everybody, this is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com. Today we're going to learn about America's 22nd president, who also happened to be America's 24th president, Grover Cleveland. Stephen Grover Cleveland was born in New Jersey in 1837. As a boy, he preferred to be called Grover instead of Stephen. Grover started school at 11 years old and later attended Hamilton College. Sadly, while he was in college, his father died. Because of this, Grover's mother could not pay for his college tuition anymore. So Grover went to New York and became a teacher. Interestingly, he decided to move out west, but while moving, he stopped in the city of Buffalo, New York, and ended up staying there permanently. While he was in Buffalo, Mr. Cleveland became a lawyer and a sheriff. People liked him because he worked hard to eliminate crime. Unlike some of the previous presidents, Mr. Cleveland never fought in the Civil War. When the war began, Mr. Cleveland paid someone, a Polish immigrant, to go and fight for him. This was completely legal for him to do under the Federal Conscription Act. In 1881, the people in Buffalo elected Mr. Cleveland as their mayor. He became very popular, and because of that, he was later elected as the governor of New York in 1882. Since he was so popular in the state of New York, the Democrats chose him as their candidate for the next presidential election. However, when he ran for president in 1884, Mr. Cleveland faced many problems. He was a Democrat, and the Republicans had discovered that he had done something controversial earlier in his life. They tried to use this against him, but because Mr. Cleveland was so popular, he still won the presidential election. During his first term, President Cleveland worked to help Native Americans buy land in America and also helped to make America's debt smaller. He did this by stopping the people in Congress from spending too much money. As a result, America's debt decreased during his presidency. In 1886, while he was president, Mr. Cleveland married Frances Folsom in the White House. They had 5 children together. In 1888, Grover Cleveland ran for president against Benjamin Harrison, but lost. 4 years later, in 1892, Mr. Cleveland ran against Benjamin Harrison again, and this time won. Mr. Cleveland and his wife, Frances, went back to the White House in 1893. Grover Cleveland was the only president to serve 2 non-consecutive terms. This means that his 2 terms were not in a row or back-to-back. During his second term, the Panic of 1893 occurred. This caused many businesses and banks to lose all of their money. President Cleveland refused to have the federal government help because he thought the country could fix itself. This made Mr. Cleveland very unpopular with many people, and this caused him not to be re-elected. In 1897, Grover Cleveland went back home to New Jersey and died there on June 24th, 1908, at age 71. An interesting fun fact is that one of Grover Cleveland's 5 children was named Ruth. The candy bar, Baby Ruth, was named after her. This is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com, and until next time, go learn your history!